Struggle is always part of the story. My story starts June 3rd, 2006. We hit a IED roadside bomb that blew my vehicle two stories in the air, flipped us over, left us in a crater 10 feet wide, 4 feet deep. My life would forever be changed.
So many things that people go through and I think they're afraid to talk about. I think there's so many people are afraid to talk about their journey in this profession.
I don't go into those situations without a plan B and a plan Z. That way I know that I can give my 100.
It's not something that I really want to do, but that it's something that I should do and need to do in order to grow and to better serve my athlete.
That continual improvement as we make our way through this field and making sure that we are our best selves for our student athletes.
It was 4 years of looking for my purpose and my meaning before God opened that door and I started racing.
Your values, your ethics, your morals, your principles don't ever change over time. What evolves is your mindset, your programs, and your philosophy.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Everything. Everything gonna be all right this morning. Oh yeah.
Thank you so much, and your talk is a perfect segue into our next speaker. Because I do believe that no matter where you're at in life, you always need that coach. And Tom Davis is my coach. You know, this is a guy that has helped me a tremendous amount on a hand cycle, but also life perspective. The guy is one of the toughest people I've ever been around, ever. You know, his resume is extensive. He's a military veteran. That service made him, you know, give almost the ultimate sacrifice for our freedom and for everything that we're able to do each day. But it also led him to hand cycling. And the guys, as humble as they could be, and his numbers are incredible. So let me just go through them real quick. Multiple-time national champion, but that doesn't give it justice because he's a 14-time national champion. He's 3-time silver medalist at the world championship level, and he's also an Olympian. The guy is one of the toughest men I've ever been around, and it's an incredible honor to have him come and share his story. So without further ado, I'm turning it over to you, Coach Tom Davis.
Thank you, Tom. Let me share my screen here. Okay, so I'm going to share with you a couple things today that I've learned in the last 14 years that I've transitioned from being a soldier to becoming a Paralympian. First one, struggle is always part of the story. Okay. For today's purpose, my story starts June 3rd, 2006. I was a sergeant. I was leading a patrol, Humvee patrol, through the streets of Ramadi, Iraq. It was at nighttime. Ramadi at that time was probably the most violent anti-American place in the world. Our patrol was ambushed. We hit a IED roadside bomb that blew my vehicle two stories in the air. Flipped us over, left us in a crater 10 feet wide, 4 feet deep. One soldier lost his life, two others were injured, and we were immediately ambushed from the surrounding rooftops. My life would forever be changed. Broke both my arms, fractured my right knee, fractured the back of my skull, fractured a vertebrae in my back, eventually amputated my left leg, as well as invisible injuries like this. Depression, post-traumatic stress, traumatic brain injury. And those are just as challenging as any of the visible injuries. But believe it or not, what I came here to talk to you about is how these things serve a purpose. Three things that I've learned. Struggles will make you stronger. Spent 15 months in a hospital. Every day I watched soldiers who couldn't deal with adversity that they were facing. Drinking, doing drugs, killing themselves. I said that wasn't going to be me. Committed to healing physically, mentally, and emotionally. Committed to learn how to walk again. And when that didn't work out, I learned how to do everything from a wheelchair. I had to relearn how to do all the simple tasks, such as like cooking, going to the store. I had to develop methods just to be able to remember everyday things. I had to relearn how to adapt back into society. overcome things like how to drive past a pothole and not be in fear of it blowing up. And those things take time, you know, just like what we're dealing with now with COVID is there's no overnight fix. But I know one thing is that I'm much stronger that I've had to go through all of this. And it makes the challenges that I'm going through now, dealing with everything, the upcoming Paralympics being canceled, it makes it that much easier to deal with. Next thing I've learned, it makes you adapt. You know, we've all realized that things happen that are not part of our plan. You know, the game plan changes all the time. That's just life. Everything that was my identity, my purpose, my way of life was ripped away from me. And that's not easy to adapt to. There's a saying, though, that when God closes a door, he opens another one. And he did that. When I was in therapy, I was introduced to a hand cycle, which is similar to a bike, but it has three wheels instead of two, and I use my arms to pedal instead of my legs. Since 2011, when I really started riding and training, I've been racing and riding it all over the world. National championships, 12 World Cup medals, and 3 World Championship medals. I was a Paralympian in Rio in 2016, and I even had the marathon world record for a while, 58 minutes, 38 seconds, when I won Boston in 2017. It may sound like I was an instant success, but I assure you that's far from the truth. And that's my next point, is that struggles will teach you to persevere through hard times. It was 4 years of looking for my purpose and my meaning before God opened that door and I started racing. I had to lose over 80 pounds to get to my current race weight. For every medal that I've won, there have been many losses, and they were often on the biggest stages. Rio Paralympics were probably two of the worst races I ever had because I let the pressure get to me. World Championships from 2015 to 18 all ended in mechanical failures, flat tires, crashing, injuries. Of all those years that I proved that I was one of the best in the world, my best finish was only a 6th place, though. So next major point I want to leave with you, determine how you're going to define success. When I prepared my men to go to Ramadi, I told them that success was bringing everyone home alive, and success was the only thing that mattered. But let's be honest. The next time that you athletes step on the field to play, no one's trying to kill you. When you drive home tonight from work, you don't have to worry about the road exploding. In sports, there are many different ways to judge success other than win or lose. If you've never read anything by Coach John Wooden, I highly recommend it. His philosophy is that success is personal in its definition. My definition of success is different than yours because we have lived two completely different lives. Also, the definition of success will change over time. First race I ever did was successful because I judged success on a time that I wanted to achieve. My first national championship gold medal was a success because it showed me that if I dedicate myself, I can achieve big things. However, when I got to the elite level of my sport, I got stuck judging my seasons as failures simply because I wasn't on the podium. After doing that for several years, I redefined my definition of success. I did my very best every day to become the best I could be according to my potential and not in comparing myself with others. So how does all this come together? World Championships in 2018, I crashed and I injured my arm. Two races that I once again should have medaled in, I placed 10th and didn't finish. Then I came home and found out I had a precancerous polyp in my colon, which required surgery. A couple months after that, I broke my ribs in a freak snow tubing accident. At the national championships in 2019, my rear wheel imploded, which caused me to crash, get injured again, and not finish. About that same time, I developed carpal tunnel syndrome in my right hand. If you don't know what that is, it makes your hand go numb, tingling, kind of like when it falls asleep. It's kind of a big deal when you use your hands for everything. You know, before everything else, this would have destroyed me. My identity and my purpose were being threatened again, but I accepted it as part of my story. I relied on the strength the Lord had given me. I adapted my training, my mindset, my attitude. I focused on doing my best in workouts every day instead of worrying about what was going to happen in races. Those changes led to peace and happiness going into the 2019 World Championships. I again had hopes of earning 2 medals. I ended up with 3 silver medals, and I even helped a teammate earn his first medal. That is success on every level. In closing, next week's going to be the 14th anniversary of June 3rd, 2006. That night will always be a failure because Specialist Brett Tribble did not come home. His son will never know his dad. 14 years after your career is over, do you want to live with the regrets that you failed yourself, your team, or those you were supposed to lead? Welcome today's struggle and do everything you can to make sure you are successful and you will never regret that. Thank you.